This documentary is about Liam Mellows. He was an Irish Republican and an Irish patriot. He has huge connections to Castletown in County Wexford and the surrounding areas.
Although he was an Irish Republican, his father was in the British Army. His mother, Sarah Jordan, was from Inch, a short distance from here.
Liam was just 30 years old when he died, but he left a lasting legacy on the history of Ireland.
Many people believe that Liam took an interest in Irish history due to his early life spent here in Wexford.
The 1798 legacy and the commemorations in 1898 would have affected Liam, and there were many stories still surviving in the area from that time. These include stories relating to Anthony Perry, the three MacDonald brothers, and the burning of the church by yeomen following the rising.
During the filming of this documentary, we visited my granddad, Ned Purcell, who was related to Liam Mellows.
Liam Mellows was sent by the IRA, the old IRA, to organise the IRA in Galway. Liam Mellows' grandfather, Liam Mellows' father, was a soldier in the British Army, and they were sent over from England. And he married my grandmother.
In the years leading up to the 1916 Rising, Liam spent much of his time between Dublin, Galway and Wexford.
Aside from the Rising in Dublin in 1916, the only other counties that rose that week were Wexford, Galway and Meath. Liam played a huge role in the Rising in Athenry. After the Rising was put down, he escaped to America.
However, this didn't go as planned, as World War I was still raging, and because the Irish volunteers had received weapons from Germany, the American authorities saw them as allies to the Germans. Liam was imprisoned without trial in the Tombs Prison in New York. He was eventually released in 1918 after the ending of World War I.
And Liam returned to Wexford to fight the British forces in what would be known as the War of Independence.
Liam fought in this area alongside many other volunteers, including Dennis and Jack Kavanagh, Danny Allen and many others.
Dennis Kavanagh was my great-grandfather, and I heard stories about Liam Mellows from my great-aunt Mary Kenny.
He used to be up in Granny's, used to play cards, and Granny used to always give him his tea, and he was a lovely, I didn't know, of course I wasn't even born I think when he was around, but he lived only down the road from my home place.
Apparently there were loads of places, including this graveyard in Castletown and the woods in Hyde Park, where the local men were hid out during the Troubles.
There was hideouts in Hyde Park in the woods, hideouts all over the place. And my father, they called my father Starlight, because he was always out at night. And that's where that name come from, Starlight Cabinet. And my granny used to go out every night with meals to them, to the hideouts. Every night she went out.
Mary also told us some stories about how the men would meet in the corner of the field for Mass while they were out fighting.
They used to go to Mass every Sunday morning in that corner of that field. And they used to have briars and bushes all around it so they wouldn't be seen. But someone spied on them, as they call them, a turncoat. And they were caught. So just before they got them, they got out. They got freed, they got away. So they put in a different little place then, and they were okay. Mass continued.
Dennis Kavanagh was also my great-grandfather, and Mary told us some other stories about how my great-granny would bring food out to the men in the fields and also clean their guns.
And my granny used to clean their guns out every night. And one night, she always said, "Are you sure there's nothing in them?" And they'd say, "Oh, no, no, no." And one night she was cleaning it and dropped to the ceiling. They forgot to take something out.
The War of Independence finally came to a halt, with the British offering a new free state where part of Ulster would remain under British rule, and a treaty was signed agreeing to this. 6 counties in Ulster would remain under British rule, while the remaining 26 under the government of the new free state.
This proved to be a dividing point among the fellow countrymen, who only months beforehand were comrades. Whilst Liam and many more considered the Anglo-Irish Treaty as a betrayal of the Irish Republic they had fought for.
To this day, many older people won't talk about it, as it opens old wounds. Unfortunately, civil wars happen in nearly all countries that have gained independence, and hopefully now we can reflect on that period in our history and learn from it.
My father now, if he saw something on television with a war or someone getting killed or something, he'd cry. And we didn't, we were too young to know why he was crying. He'd never tell us. He never once spoke about it. It was my mother told us and my relations and all them. So God rest him, he died in, he was 76 years when he died. He died in 75. And my mother only lived a year and a half after him.
Liam was arrested in June 1922 by pro-treaty forces due to his involvement in the siege of the Four Courts in Dublin. Liam, along with fellow Republicans Rory O'Connor, Joe McKevley and Richard Barrett, among others, entered the buildings. Days later, it was bombarded by Free State forces. Mellows had a chance to escape along with Ernie O'Malley but did not take it.
This was to be the last time Liam was to be imprisoned, as just 6 months later, on the 8th of December 1922, he was executed in Mountjoy Jail.
The night before they executed him, they only gave him, I think, 4 or 5 hours when they shot him then. And those four, they took one from each province to show up Michael Collins' army that they were the throne leaders. So that's what they happened there.
This was as a reprisal for the shooting of a pro-treaty TD, Sean Hales, on the 7th of December on his way to the Dáil.
At 3:30 a.m. on the 8th of December, Mellows, McKelvey, Barrett and O'Connor received the following message, signed on behalf of the Army Council by General Richard Mulcahy.
You are hereby notified that being a person taken in arms against the government, you will be executed at 8 a.m. on Friday the 8th of December as a reprisal for the assassination of Brigadier Sean Hales, TD, in Dublin.
Although he was the TD for Connacht when he was executed, he chose to be buried in Wexford, in this village of Castletown, with the people he grew up with and loved.
They brought him back, they reinterred him in Castletown up here. He said he wanted to be reinterred among his own country people, now doing the pomp and ceremony of Dublin. And De Valero unveiled the monument to Liam Mellows up here on the 8th of December 1945. I can remember that well.
Liam is buried in this graveyard here in Castletown. There's an annual commemoration where wreaths are laid on his grave. Wreaths are also laid on the graves of my own family members, the Kavanaghs.
And our local GA club is called Castletown Liam Mellows. In nearby Arklow, there are two places named after him called Mellows Avenue and Mellows Close.
There is a Liam Mellows Street in Tuam, County Galway. In Wexford Town, there is a complete housing estate named after Liam called Liam Mellows Estate. There is also a bridge named after him in Dublin, while there is another hurling club in Galway named in his memory.
Liam will always be remembered here, and his connection to Castletown and the surrounding area will never be forgotten.
We are very proud of Liam, and he will always be remembered in Castletown.